Hello, welcome. In today's video, we're going to clear up a question many people still have, in 2025, which Nintendo Switch emulators offer the best performance, and ensure the best compatibility to play most of the console's library without headaches. That's what we'll find out after a word from our sponsors. If you want to buy original games while saving a lot, check out Instant Gaming, the digital store that sells games for various platforms, such as PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and Nintendo Switch. Get games of all genres with discounts of up to 95%. You'll also find a variety of gift cards and credits for other services. You can pay for your order through your credit card on a website with a 4.7 rating on Trustpilot. You're buying games directly from Instant Gaming, not from other retailers. If you encounter any issues, Instant Gaming offers 24/7 support. Get the highly acclaimed Hogwarts Legacy now, in its base version for $11.44 and the deluxe version for $14.15. Check out the price comparison with Steam's pricing. What are you waiting for to save? Before we dive into the tests, let's talk a little about the main Nintendo Switch emulators. Starting with Citroen, a fork of Yuzu created to add new features and increase compatibility with games that remained unplayable on the original Yuzu. Currently, I consider Citroen to be the Yuzu fork with the best compatibility for more recent games. I'm part of the testing team for the project, and I can already tell you that in the next update, issues that have existed since Yuzu will finally be fixed. The developer behind Citroen is known for listening to the community, though the project often faces attacks from haters. Among its highlights is the frame generator support in the Android version. The version I'm using is an improvement of 0.4, with the only difference being the fix for the Discord status. Sudachi is a project surrounded by controversies. Its developer abandoned it for a while but has recently returned to work on it, though he has said that he will approach the project in a less hardcore way. Some say he temporarily gave up because he was just copying the fixes from Ryujinx, and when the original project ended, he was left without new references. Additionally, he doesn't interact much with the community. I've tried to reach out but haven't gotten a response. Sudachi has the same features as Yuzu, with slightly better compatibility but still below Citroen's level. Ryujinx, specifically the Green Dev fork, is currently the most popular. This version can be considered a direct continuation of the original Ryujinx, but now with the use of hacks to improve performance. If you compare the latest official Ryujinx version with the current Green Dev version, you'll notice these changes easily. The emulator has also received significant improvements, such as the ability to store all downloads in a single folder, with files being automatically loaded when you run a game. The interface has also been improved, while maintaining the accuracy of the original project. However, the developer is rarely present in the community, and many criticize the official Ryujinx Discord for being extremely toxic. Personally, I've never had problems with the community, but I know people close to me who have. Another interesting project is Torzu, which has followed a path similar to Citroen, implementing innovative features, improving compatibility, and updating several dependencies, including Vulkan enhancements. The big problem is its availability only on the dark web, making it less accessible than other emulators. I didn't include it in the tests because it shares a large portion of the code with Citroen, resulting in virtually identical performance. Before we get into the tests, if you like this kind of content, please leave a like, and if this is your first time here on the channel, consider subscribing to stay updated with more tests and future updates. Let's start with Bayonetta 3. I've already made a video in the past about the best way to play it, and since then, not much has changed. However, before talking about the performance on each emulator, it's important to remember that Yuzu Forks received a fix before the original project was discontinued, resulting in a performance boost of about 66% in this game. This means that if you've faced audio desynchronization issues during cutscenes in the past, know that this problem has been completely fixed in the Yuzu Forks. The only exception is if your PC can't maintain at least 30 FPS in the game, as desynchronization may still occur in that case. Another important point is that Bayonetta 3 requires almost all the potential of the Switch, which makes the game use several graphical concessions to maintain a stable FPS. Depending on your PC, you can make the most of the game by using mods for 900p and removing the grainy filter. I'll leave my mod library in the description for anyone who wants to test it. It's also worth noting that in some versions of the emulator, polygon breaks can be seen in the game's fog effects. This issue is present in both Citroen and Ryujinx, but it doesn't occur in Sudachi. I've already informed the Citroen team, and they've found a solution. If this bothers you, simply disable MSAY. This incompatibility happens in both Citroen and Ryujinx due to the new NVIDIA driver. However, I recommend keeping MSAY enabled as it significantly improves the game's graphical quality, which is already quite limited. As I'm editing this video, This bug has been fixed in internal builds of Citroen. In fact, I'm using a version with this fix. Another important detail is the high VRAM usage. This happens because the game is not running at its native resolution, but at 1800p, thanks to a 900p mod with the internal resolution doubled. Now, directly speaking about the performance, I ran two types of tests. The first was a maximum FPS test to determine which emulator can achieve the highest frame rate. I chose a fixed area of the game with no movement to avoid any variables that could affect the results. Here, Ryujinx had a decisive win, averaging 185 FPS, while Citroen and Sudachi were between 120 and 125 FPS. Despite Ryujinx's higher performance, the experience isn't optimal due to desynchronization. Therefore, I recommend Citroen, which offers a more stable experience and extremely fast shader compilation. The second test was in intense action scenes, with many enemies on the screen, a giant creature, and constant summons. The performance was measured considering the low 1%, which tracks shader compilation time. The slower this process, the more the emulator's minimum FPS drops. Citroen stood out again for its new shader compilation method, which proved to be very effective, keeping the FPS almost stable. In other emulators, performance drops significantly during action. Another game tested was Fast RMX, requested by Patreon supporter Ivylin, and I'd like to thank everyone who supports the channel. I had tested this game a while ago and knew it had several compatibility issues. The good news is that it now works on the Yuzu Forks, but the frame rate is still unstable. In Ryujinx, the game crashes right at the start, as you can see. Analyzing performance on Citroen and Sudachi, I noticed that the game can reach almost 100 FPS in some areas, but in others, it struggles to maintain 30 FPS. Overall, Sudachi performs better with fewer drops, but they still happen. Mario Kart 8 is probably the easiest game to run from this list, performing well on almost every platform, even on Android. This time, Ryujinx had the worst performance, being over 100 FPS behind the competitors. Focusing only on Citroen and Sudachi, Sudachi wins by exactly 10 FPS, but when looking at the low 1%, Citroen simply crushes Sudachi. If you have a more basic PC, Sudachi may give you some extra FPS, but Citroen hardly has any stutters when compiling new shaders, making it the best option in my opinion. I also tested Pokemon Scarlet, and in this case, the numbers don't tell the whole story. Even though the Yuzu Forks have a higher frame rate, when entering populated cities, performance drops significantly. Additionally, there are occasional vertex explosions in both Citroen and Sudachi. In Ryujinx, the performance is slightly lower, but more stable in populated areas. Since you won't be playing Pokemon at accelerated speed, as 90 FPS is 3 times the original speed, I consider Ryujinx the better choice. However, if your PC is more modest, both Citroen and Ryujinx can give you some extra FPS that will make a difference. Shadow Generations, recently released, still has issues on most emulators. However, two of them already consider the game playable, Torzu and Citroen. In Sudachi, the game starts but crashes after about 1 or 2 minutes of gameplay. In Citroen, to run correctly, it's necessary to set the GPU accuracy to accurate. This setting doesn't fix the issue in Sudachi, though. Despite the limitations, I compared Citroen and Sudachi, and once again, the results were similar. However, Citroen's advantage lies in the low 1%, showing that its new shader compilation method is truly efficient. Another game that had problems on Yuzu Forks for a long time but is now in good shape is Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. In this case, the numbers don't always reflect the actual experience. For the test, I chose the same stage with 8 CPU-controlled characters. Since the game has numerous variations during gameplay, the emulator is constantly compiling hundreds of shaders. In terms of FPS, Citroen delivers the best results and is the most recommended option, especially for more modest PCs. Sudachi comes second, and Ryujinx is third. However, if you're planning to play the campaign mode, known as World of Light, for several consecutive hours, Ryujinx is the best choice. Citroen and Sudachi crash after about 45 minutes of gameplay, apparently due to memory leaks caused by the large number of shaders. Ryujinx, on the other hand, can run for over 4 hours before experiencing these crashes. Another game that I always get asked about is Sonic Frontiers. The game still has issues on any Yuzu fork. I'm working with the Citroen team to try to resolve this, so if you're using any Yuzu fork, don't bother trying to play the game on Vulkan, as it will crash before reaching the main menu. This is especially problematic for AMD GPU users, who face difficulties with drivers to run the game on OpenGL. On OpenGL, both Citroen and Sudachi can run the game well, but it's important to note that using this API, while resolving the issue, significantly reduces performance and causes many stutters when compiling new shaders. Speaking of numbers, the first discrepancy is the VRAM usage on Ryujinx, but I probably forgot to configure the game to run with double the internal resolution, as the global video setting is the only one available. So, disregard this information. Generally speaking, comparing the performance of a game running on Vulkan with another running on OpenGL is almost impossible, as the Vulkan API is years ahead of OpenGL. However, Sudachi was the only emulator that couldn't maintain an average of 60 FPS in this test, and the low 1% was only 1 FPS, meaning there were severe stutters that practically froze the gameplay. Now, about Zelda Echoes of Wisdom. Unfortunately, the audio problem hasn't been fixed in either Citroen or Sudachi. However, I see Zephyron, the Citroen developer, saying they are focused on fixing this issue, so we might have some updates soon. Another fix that will be brought to Citroen is the rendering of the rifts that don't appear on Android. I've even seen an image showing the rifts rendered correctly. In terms of performance, Sudachi performed slightly better than Citroen, but again, it lost in the low 1%. Ryujinx came last. However, since no one is going to play this game above 180 FPS, as that would be a waste of performance and power, I recommend using Ryujinx until the audio issues are fixed. But if you're having trouble keeping the game stable on Ryujinx, you can use the Yuzu forks. Lastly, one of the platform's flagship games, Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. The last time I tested the game in one of the previous videos, Citroen outperformed Sudachi, but some people mentioned that this wasn't shown in the video. This happened because I recorded for several minutes and didn't include everything in the edit. Only later did I take the average of each emulator and compared them. But this time, the result was even more unexpected. If someone had told me that one day Ryujinx would outperform any Yuzu fork in Tears of the Kingdom, I would have probably laughed a lot, but that's exactly what happened. I don't know the exact reason, but it was revealed that Ryujinx Green Dev added some speed hacks. I'm not sure when exactly they surpassed the Yuzu forks, but it happened. As you can see, the impossible happened, with Ryujinx delivering superior performance and a reasonable low 1%, though consuming almost 19 gigabytes of memory. So, for those with only 16 gigabytes of RAM, there will definitely be performance drops. Ryujinx's frame time has always been strange, and they recommend locking the frame via the GPU manager. I don't know if this advantage was only in the underground, but it occurred. If you're getting better performance in Ryujinx with this game, leave your result in the comments. To conclude, as you can see, each project has advantages in some games and disadvantages in others. Overall, I recommend having at least one Yuzu fork and the Green Dev Ryujinx available and testing the games to see where they run best. This varies from system to system, and the game engine and optimization will also be key factors. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.